Over the weekend, US President Donald Trump notched up his 100th day in office. As tradition dictates, the US media took a break from having people just shout over the top of each other and gathered ordinary Americans to grade the president's performance.
I would say I'd give him a B+.
Right now, I'd give him a C-.
F.
An I for incomplete and incompetent.
Ooh, someone got a dictionary for Christmas. CNN hit the cable TV sweet spot, gathering ordinary Americans together to grade Trump while talking over each other.
I saw the tape. I don't know what you saw.
Yeah, unwatchable. Trump himself tried to keep media conversations to a minimum.
You can take it any way you want.
But I'm asking you, because you don't want it to be fake news. I want to hear it from President Trump.
You don't have to ask me.
Why not?
Because I have my own opinions. You can have your own opinions.
But I want to know your opinions. You're the President of the United States.
It's enough. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, he's the president. He shouldn't have to put up with tricky gotcha questions like, what is your opinion? They're so sneaky like that, the media. But it wasn't all aggression. In fact, in one interview, we got the very rare introspective Trump.
I loved my previous life. I loved my previous life. I had so many things going. I actually, this is more work than in my previous life. I thought it would be easier. I like to work, so that's not a problem. But this is actually more work.
Come on, he probably assumed, like we all did, that running the world's largest economy and the world's most powerful military would be easier than hosting a reality show and spruiking aftershave. But now that he understands what a difficult job he has, how does Trump grade himself?
I truly believe that the first 100 days of my administration has been just about the most successful in our country's history.
Yeah, I had a feeling he'd say that. To grade the president's grading, please welcome Tom Gleason and Kitty Flanagan. Oh, wait. No. This isn't how it's done. Can we get them in boxes, please? Boxes? Oh, that's much better. That's great. So, Tom, how do you grade the first 100 days?
Oh, that's a stupid question, Charlie. He still has ages to go. That's like someone judging this show just by watching the first minute and a half and not even waiting until I turned up.
And Kitty, the first 100?
Yeah, I agree with Tom. It's a stupid question. What else have you got?
Right, well, why don't we look at some of his promises and how they've panned out. First off, the travel ban, as many and he called the Muslim ban.
Yeah, look, I'd never support a travel ban for Muslims, but as someone who flies a lot, if tomorrow they announced a ban on anyone who reclined their seat on a flight from Sydney to Melbourne, I'm all for it. It's an hour and a half, people. Just sit up. An hour and a half. It's not that hard.
He also made an attempt to pass healthcare. He promised it in 100 days, but it didn't succeed. Tom?
Yeah, he failed. So what? So he'll have another go. Don't worry about it. For Trump, trying to pass a bill is much like marriage. If it fails, you just have another go. In the meantime, you fool around with a few younger pieces of legislation.
OK, now, one of Trump's biggest promises is that he would build a wall and that Mexico would pay for it. And as of this week, no-one's going to build the wall and no-one is going to pay for it.
Yeah, well, that's exactly right, Chuck, because no-one is building walls anymore. Have you not watched Grand Designs? If you're trying to block out your neighbours, bamboo is a wonderful natural screening product. Some varieties grow to upwards of 20 feet and if you're lucky, you might even attract some panda.
OK, well, what about North Korea? Trump could be dragging us into a war.
North Korea's despotic regime unleashed its own threat, warning of a potential nuclear attack on Australia's mainland.
Together, we're taking a strong message to North Korea that we will not tolerate reckless, dangerous threats to the peace and stability of our region.
That was Prime Minister Turnbull and a generator. Kitty, North Korea?
I think we're all making a mistake. I think North Korea and the US are about to form an alliance because Trump envies Kim Jong-un. He would love that kind of power. When Kim Jong says, no health care for anyone, the people applaud. When Kim Jong says, no one gets in or out of this country, the people applaud. And when Kim Jong says, I want to wear my hair in this ridiculous fashion, the people love it.
OK, but North Korea have even singled out Darwin as a target. Tom, should we be worried?
Oh, have you been to Darwin? They're the toughest people on the planet. It's already 20 million degrees. If a nuke went off there, they'd probably yell out, "Hey, Mum, the cool change is here."
Well, we only have about 10 seconds left. Would you like to both talk over each other?
Oh, yeah, sure.
If I could just say one thing. If you would let me finish, Tom.
If there's just one thing I could say.
Let me finish.
I'm afraid we're now out of time.
One thing.
I'm finished.